First, try to subtract 9 from 3 to reveal the answer from a factorial of any number. Then, replace the answer, without parentheses this time, to show only a factorial number of 6.
Now you have a factorial of 9 on top, and a factorial of 6 times a factorial of 3 on the bottom. So in order for this to work, you'll need to figure out what 9 can go and stop at. As you can guess clearly, the number 9 stops at 7, but never the number 6. This is between functions of determining and explaining the question and answer on how it should stop at while counting down. Here is how a probability event should look like.
So, here are the 5 high school / college students in a randomized order. Suppose that the students are in forms of animals, a bear, a tiger, a rabbit, a deer, and a lion. In order for the students to participate, they must form a line in order by its alphabetical sorting.
First, if Blackwood Bear can be in one place by Christopher the male deer, they'll be able to switch or keep lines as possible. If you want to make Christopher the male deer switch groups with Dominic the deer, let the deer be in the second row. Or, if Christopher the male deer is in another class period, Dominic the deer can be behind Blackwood Bear. We can contain this permutation as possible. If necessary, continue sorting in alphabetical order and remember it clearly. First, is Blackwood. Second, is Dominic. Third is Leonard.
Fourth is Rogers. Keep continuing to follow the students in line and in alphabetical order until you reach the last student.
Fifth is Terence. Note the last student you see in a permutation while sorting out the students in line. You may notice the tiger on the right is still standing next to the rabbit on the left.
This is what's called a process of permutation.
As soon as class starts, a change of sorting is recommended.
So if Blackwood comes first with Dominic, it will be randomly sorted to pick the student at any period.
For example, if Blackwood Bear would trade seats with Rogers the Rabbit, it will not affect the permutation sequence. That way, the bear over there is next to the rabbit on the right, so that each of the students are not looking at them while class is in session or in progress.
So now, try to find the answer of 9 times 8 multiplied by 7.
Start with 9 times 8 to equal 72 multiplied by 7 and you get 504 of the answer. Now you have on top, 9 times 8 multiplied by 7, and a factorial of the number 3 on the bottom. So the only way to find out is to simplify 504 by 3.
When you find the fraction you see, you can write it in simplest form. So the answer for 9 times 8 multiplied by 7 over the factorial of the number 3 is 84.
Now you see the answer you've made changes to. Try to think the differences of permutation and combination in math. It's like counting backwards while multiplying, but you need factorial expressions based on a number.
If you think the problem is based on an NPR formula, then a permutation is required. But if the problem is based on an NCR formula, a combination is required also.